That is his
Yes.
commitment. And also NTR Memorial Trust, they have done very well. Mrs. Bhuvaneswari and also Rajendra Kumar, they have extended all the support. We created one of the best ecosystem, what all possible within our limits, in mobilizing funds or spending money, giving oxygen plants. Even he has given so many oxygen plants. Even NTR Memorial Trust sanctioned 6 oxygen plants, and all these things we are doing. With this again and again, I am thankful to you on behalf of the society for your extraordinary services. Even I have written letters to all frontline warriors for your services, extraordinary services. Now, one side, we have to take the support of the government, and at the same time, we have to move to protect ourselves against Wave 3. With this, I'm thanking all of you. Thank you. Thank you, Ananda.
Thank you so much, sir, for your kind words. You have been an inspiration always. I would, before I, you know, speak about COVID, I would like to say that when I started my journey as an actor, and I used to shoot in Hyderabad and all these neighboring places, you know, and I always used to say Hyderabad looks so beautiful. It's so well maintained, the kind of infrastructure that has come, the IT that has come, you know, how come this is so beautiful? And the only name that used to come was, it's only because of Chandrababu Naidu, sir. And he's the man, he's a visionary who gave this facelift to this whole state. And I always used to tell my staff and the co-actors, can we take Chandrababu Naidu, sir, to our states also for some time so that we can also see that progress. So I think that was my introduction to you till I met, till we connected during the COVID times. And it's really a pleasure, sir, always, you know, getting inspired by the great work that you have been doing. And, you know, I always say that, you know, Andhra, Telangana now, you know, it's been my second home. My wife is from, you know, Andhra, she's a Telugu, I don't know how many people know that, from the Godavari district. So there's a certain connection that was always there before even I started my movie career. And all the love that has been given, it's that brings me back again to my, I would say, my people. And and with COVID, I think the bond has grown stronger. We have connected with so many people, so many heroes. A small example I would like to give is that when when I was sending people back home, I connected to almost 1 million people who approached me during the migrant movement. And you know, and when once the first wave subsided, you know, and these people had their education problems, their healthcare problems, and their employment. So we gave, I started this platform called Pravasi Rozgar, which was later, you know, called Good Worker with MSEC. We have given employment to almost close to 2 lakh people, done almost 2,400 surgeries, many in Andhra and Telangana, most of them. And, you know, obviously education also. And I realized that people thought that second wave has subsided and everything is coming to normal. Actually, second wave started even before the second wave actually began. The second wave for me was the problems that people had because of the first wave. They had lost their jobs. They didn't have money to, you know, feed their families. They didn't have employment. They didn't have money to get treated. So actually, we were living in that second wave. But the second wave, we again, that hit the COVID thing where people were losing lives. And all these people said that it connected during the first wave. All these people became my workforce. You know, they said, you know, sir, we are in, you know, Vikarabad, we are in Vijayawada. So how can we help? You had helped us go back to our homes. So they became my warriors. And, you know, and I always used to say one thing that, you know, we can only work if you are available 24/7. It's not that, you know, okay, I'm busy, I can give 4 hours. I said, you know, in the middle of night, someone has a medical emergency, I'm going to call you in the middle of night that you have to help. This is a very one example that I would like to give. Varun is there also today in our forum. And, you know, in the night at 2:30, once I got a image on my WhatsApp, which one image which said oxygen level 60. And there's no message from where that random WhatsApp became just a picture of that oximeter reading 60. So I called that guy and he said, where are you? He said, sir, I'm in Kukatpally in Hyderabad, and this is my father's oxygen level, and I don't know whether he's going to survive or not. So I called Varun around 1:32, and whole night we were coordinating. We took him to the hospital. We gave him some emergency, oxygen levels. We improved, and then he was shifted to that hospital. And 4 days ago, he was discharged. And I said, can you send me the picture of your father? And the father was hale and hearty. And I thought that, if I would have thought that, should I call someone at 2 o'clock in the night or 3 o'clock, disturb a doctor or someone, so that gentleman wouldn't have survived. So my request to all of you is, when you need to call someone or you need to save a life, just call them. Don't think also, I have disturbed Chandrababu Naidu sir also once, in the middle of night, I messaged him, sir, please help. And someone from your team shifted a patient in the first wave from one hospital to other, and we got to save them. So the biggest lesson that I learned during these 15 months is that don't think so that we are not capable to do something. Sometimes a lot of people say, where to start, I don't know, how to help, I don't know, I'm financially not capable to help anyone, so how can I help? I'll become one big businessman, or I'll earn a lot of money, then I'll start my help. So my suggestion to all of those people is, don't underestimate your power. You don't need money to help. You just need that one phone call to call someone for help. If someone is having a problem, you can call any one of us. That's why there's a problem. And if you are able to save that individual, I think you have done your job as a warrior. So I feel COVID is the biggest professor that the world saw. It taught us empathy. It taught us what humanity is. It taught us how a normal person can save a life. So take it as a lesson of a life that, it's not about whether you are capable of doing it or not. You have to believe you are capable of doing it. I as an individual, I always used to act. I never knew that I can get 12,500 students from places like Kyrgyzstan, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, Russia, Philippines, Georgia. But I got them because I believed that I can get them. I was sending medicines, I was sending injections to people, I was trying to get them ICU beds, oxygen. So I'm learning every single day. Every day I wake up, there's someone who teaches me a lesson that, Sonu, you can do it, and I try to do it. Like I said, we are starting with almost 18 oxygen plants across the states. So people say, yeah, why not Punjab? You are from Punjab. Why not Maharashtra? You are living in Maharashtra. So my first 4 plants are coming in Andhra and Telangana, one in Karnool, Nellore, Hyderabad, you're planning, and one more place we are hunting for, which is a very genuine one. So my point is, humanity doesn't have any religion, any creed, any caste, any state. So I think we have to do and set examples for everyone. Like sir said, when the crisis had hit, and he had gone to Odisha and Uttarakhand and all these places, I think that is the biggest example of an individual that you can do anything if you believe that you can do it. And today, I don't know what all is written in fate, but this is our first step. I read a very nice thing in the morning. When you become rich and famous, don't try to improve the standard of living, but try to improve the standard of giving. So you have to be kind to the world. And we read our lectures, whether it's history, geography, or all these, in all these classes, I always request, it's very important to have a lecture of humanity, empathy, where from first standard till you are doing your engineering or your medical, we have to teach how important it is to learn about humanity and empathy, and especially in to our kids. When they ask for those expensive cars or the best life flight system, you have to teach them how we can go to a needy place and give them some ration, or adopt few kids for their education. So I think that's what I have learned. That's what I'm trying to learn, and I'm still open to learn. I just started this foundation called Sue Charity Foundation, And we have been doing a lot of work. And I always say that, you know, Sooth Charity Foundation is not my foundation. It's your foundation. It's a foundation of 135 crore Indians. We don't need any donations. You just have to call us. So I'm from Sooth Charity Foundation. We need this, sir. And we'll try to make things happen for you. And I think not much to say, but like I said, you all are heroes. And thank you. Thanks a ton for making a part, me a part of this family. And yes, I'm there to learn. I'm there to, you know, follow your footsteps. And let's try to change the world, set some examples, and make this world a beautiful place to live in.
Thank you. Very nice of you.
Thanks a lot, sir. Though you have a busy schedule, you joined the call, and now you've given a great insight. It's a wonderful message to a lot of youngsters in our state, sir. And definitely, we'll definitely follow it. And, you know, you said, like, you know, clearly you mentioned that, so nothing can drive anything. You know, the only thing is the intention of help would drive the philanthropy. Thanks. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We'll
sir,
meet.
I look forward, sir.
We'll meet soon.
Sir, coming forward. Sir, looking forward, and I'll come and see you very, very soon there. I will come for you, sir.
Yeah, at the earliest we'll meet, we'll work together. I'm very happy.
Yes,
I'm proud of you. Nation is proud of you.
Sir, thank you so much.
You are a great icon for serving the people when there is a need. Even everybody is taking some inspiration from you. As you rightly mentioned, there is no word impossible. Everything is possible. Only initiative is important. There are so many people, but they never initiated. But whenever there is a crisis, he is coming forward, and every day is learning. There is moving from strength to strength. Even during this crisis, I have seen so many pathetic stories. So many problems. Even I used to talk every day, 20, 30 phones, either consoling them or helping them. Even sometimes some families, totally 4 or 5 members of a family totally died. You can imagine the problem. Even Supreme Court intervened. All parents were dead. Children have become orphan. This is where even we may give some money, but we are unable to give family support. There are so many lessons all of us are learning. But very, very pathetic. But how to act, all of us has to act. I am very happy. There is a lot of work for all of us, not all possible, apart from governments. We will do our best. కాబట్టి మళ్ళీ ఒకసారి మీ అందరి తరపున మనస్ఫూర్తిగా సోను సూద్ గారిని అభినందిస్తున్నా. ఇక్కడ ఎవరైతే కోవిడ్ హీరోస్, సమ్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ నేను ఐ హావ్ సీన్ టు సర్వ్ ది పీపుల్ దే లాస్ట్ దెర్ లైఫ్స్. They know very well it is vulnerable, but never they are afraid. And in the process, they sacrificed. Really, they are all heroes. We have to salute all of them. We have to pray their soul best peace. And also they are all best examples for all of us to give continuous spirit.